From the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C.
Rivolgeresti ancor la prova. doing quite a lot of Vivaldi tonight. It's interesting, these concertos, the violin concerto you'll hear now and the cello concerto, were both written for quite a kind of extraordinary organization. It was an orphanage for young girls. Vivaldi was a priest, and he taught at this school, and it was called the Ospedale della Pietà, still in Venice. You could go and visit it, and it was very popular in the 18th century to visit, indeed to go and actually see the, try and see the orchestra play, these wonderful young girls. It was a big attraction, and part of the allure of it was that the orchestra played behind grills. And do you mind shutting the door? Sorry, what's this going on? Thank you. Behind grills, and it was hard to see the girls. Rousseau went and visited, and he said, I can think of nothing as voluptuous or as moving as this music. What grieved me were those accursed grills which allowed only tones to come through and concealed the angels of loveliness of whom they were worthy. Well, there are no grills here tonight, and so you will see in the full glory Rachel Podger at the rest of the English concert to play the Grosso Mogul.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh,
How to follow that in many different ways. We did a lot of Vivaldi tonight. He was hugely successful in his own lifetime, but at the end of his life, things turned very bad for him. He grew out of favor. He left Venice. He moved to Vienna, where he died a pauper. He was buried in a pauper's grave in Vienna, which was then tarmacked over as a ring road around Vienna. There's now a hotel standing on the site where he was buried, but they have put a little plaque up to him. He was buried in St. Stephen's Cathedral. We were by a very odd quirk of fate. In the choir, there was a boys' choir, was a 9-year-old boy called Joseph Haydn, who was singing at Vivaldi's funeral, which is a kind of extraordinary thing. A few years before, some years before in Vienna, one of the organists was Johannes Pachelbel, and we thought we'd give you a little piece of his that I hope you recognize.
This has been a presentation of the Library of Congress. Visit us at loc.gov.